Hi, I'm Gerry from Gerry's Craft Room, and in this video I'm going to make another page for my mini album. I start with stamping the flowers from the Antique Botanicals rubber dance set, and I stamp with a VersaFine ink. And I stamped a bunch of the smaller flowers too. I'm going to color a piece of watercolor paper and I add the ink to a piece of acetate and spray water. And I'm going to make some splats. I'm just letting the drops fall from the acetate on my paper. Now my camera was a bit too low. You need some space to let the splats fall. By the way, I added the products I used in the description box for you. And if you're new here and you like what you see, don't forget to subscribe. And I'm going to use a straw to spread the ink a bit. Now I use the heat tool to partly dry the ink, and I'm going to do some ink smooching with the acetate. And dry the page again. I spray water drops and I dry and blot, and the splats are still visible, and it all adds to the subtle texture. I'm going to use the same ink with a stencil, and because the ink in the background is diluted, the next layer with the same ink will perfectly match and it will stand out too. I apply it with a cheap sponge. I find stencils tend to ruin the sponge applicators. I color the planks with the same ink, and I'm going to ink the edges for a bit more color along the outside. I stamp the butterfly from the same stamp set with the same color ink, and I'm going to stamp it in different spots. I put the planks on the page to see where I wanted to add a stitching stamp, and I stamp it in different places. It needs just light pressure to get a perfect stamped image. And then I add the planks to the page. I added some foam to the back for some extra dimension. I'm going to color the flowers with pink and blue distress oxide inks. I added them to an acrylic block and used a water brush to apply them. I colored the hearts with the twisted citron again and I fussy cut all the flowers. I covered the page with some paper and I'm going to make splats with black gesso diluted with water and a fan brush. I stamped the word in the corner. Then it's time to assemble. I just lay out all the parts and move them a bit until I like where they are. And I use the hot glue gun to glue them to the page. With some extra glue you can create some dimension. And I add some big jewel drops. And this is what it looks like when the drops are dry. They really give a great finish to a page. I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. And make sure to keep on crafting!